on a digital platform, you don't really have too many limitations. You know, people come from all cultures, shapes, sizes, and you could all compete against each other, and the only thing that matters is what happens in the server.
The main way I kind of got scouted was I streamed a lot. Streaming is actually a good way for people to scout, I guess, because they can watch your stream, see how good you are, this, that, that.
The best thing about being a pro gamer is the competition. There's nothing more I live for than competing against someone else that thinks they could beat you.
I think it's easy for the outside world not to see the skill set we have.
There was actually a lot of tough competition this year. Before then, North America didn't really have stable teams back then. It was kind of only two teams that were really running the show. This year will be different.
My role on the team is the in-game leader, which is basically sort of like the tactician of the team. I operate a lot as the coach in-game, so I also play in-game, but I'm calling the strategies round by round.
Can we start coming ready? 3, 2, 1, start running.
Go in B when I tell you to, okay? You're gonna go after the first smoke, okay? And they're doing the same shot.
Blind.
So in Counter-Strike, on my team, I play kind of a lurker role, and I just try to find a gap outside of where all the action is. So if my team's hitting the A-bomb site, which is far on the right side of the map, I'm coming from the left side of the map.
Now going to be walking in. Did he spot Flusher? I think he just did. Grenade going to run in, so he knows exactly where he is. And Flusher going to be looking the wrong way in. Nothing is going to clutch it here for a double kill.
I'm kind of like the second man in. I always make sure I have my gun out. So I'm kind of like Ryan a little bit. He's the entry fragger. I kind of stay behind him. If he ever gets into like a gunfight or he dies, I make sure I'm there to pick up that person that killed him.
Gets a kill, Grim's gonna go down, Shroud showing up. It's now down to Oliver. Oh my god, he takes him down, and that's gonna be Cloud9 winning it back.
So around like 3 months ago, we started to run into some problems with our existing roster, which is when we, as a team and organization, decided we needed to make a change. We exchanged two of our players for two really rising and big talents within the North American scene. fREAKAZOID and Skadoodle both joined the team.
When I was a free agent at the time, I had a few organizations kind of scouting me, and I had to make like a hard choice because each team needed a team opper. The opper is basically the guy who picks up the sniper rifle. It's a real like heavy weapon, you kind of move slow with it, but it's a one-shot kill.
And they are going to be blasting through onto B-side. Skadoodle gets one, gets two, that's the bomb carrier down, gets inside for triple, just piling them down.
I decided that I wanted to go to Cloud9 because I felt like they were a more stable organization as a whole.
So as long as I did my sports and I did my school, and then my dad would let me play games. As I told my dad, I'm like, Dad, there's opportunities now in the game, and I'm like, I promise, like, if you give me my computer back, you're not going to be disappointed. And then like a week later, or 2 weeks later, I end up getting, it's like giving me chills right now thinking about it. But 2 weeks later, I end up getting picked up by Cloud9. So my role in, like on my team is entry fragging, which is you have to have really good timing and reactions to where the first person's gonna be, and helping out your teammates get them set up for success.
So with the addition of our new team members, came a lot of increased chemistry within the team. We've been bonding a lot more, which is huge. But even more importantly than that is the role aspect of the two new players. So kind of comparing it to American football, we were almost like playing without a wide receiver or without a running back. But with our new two team members, the roles became very solidified.
Lately on our team, I think simply we've just had more functioning roles.
It's a team game, so if you know what your team's doing, it helps you kind of get comfortable and helps you do what you gotta do.
So one of the hardest parts about being a professional gamer is you're constantly traveling.
We're going from Europe, back to North America, back to Europe, back to the United States.
So we don't really have much free time to do anything besides game.
A lot of people think we're just constantly in vacation mode because we travel around the world, but it gets pretty stressful.
You really miss your family, you really miss your bed, you miss your girlfriends.
Your skin getting dry because you're sitting on a flight for 13 hours. You left at 9 p.m. and you get to another country at 9 p.m. so you slept, but you don't know if you should sleep when you get there, and then you have to play in 2 days.
I do contribute a lot of our success lately to the amount of time that Trace, Stunna, our manager, he's taken off of our hands.
The most challenging part of the job is making sure these guys are happy and set up for success. I think that's the number one job description for what I do, is making sure that they have the tools and the stuff that they need to propel not only themselves forward in and out of game, but the team as a unit. It's like herding cats, almost.
Currently, right now, we're in the midst of a couple-day boot camp here at the HyperX offices. And what this is going to do for us is really help us refine our strategies and kind of grow tactically as a team, as well as become more immersed in the game.
We're competing to qualify for the ESL 1 Cologne Major. There's a lot of hype around it. It's basically the biggest tournaments of the year. They happen like three times a year. We're going to be competing in an arena filled with 20,000 people. It's pretty much the most prestigious setting you could have for an esports event.
Emotional state going in the major, I'm trying to keep as even keel as possible, but excited as possible. People are going to come after us, and they're going to be hungry to come and get us. And as long as we stay hungry and stay wanting to keep winning, and we're going to keep doing really well.
We feel pretty confident, but you can never underestimate anybody, because once you start underestimating, that's when they just surprise you and you're like, oh my god, we just lost.
My expectations going into the major are obviously very high. Given our recent results, I expect nothing less than at least a top two, but I'm definitely hoping for a win at this major.
So we got to Germany about a week ago, went to a boot camp facility, got here, got adjusted to our sleep schedules, and basically just turned on our computers and haven't looked back since.
Almost like a classroom environment in all the hotels prior to our matches, we'll load up a demo, which is basically a video of a replay from the team we're playing the following day.
We're basically just scouting the other team before we play them, and we assume they're doing the same thing to us, so it's kind of like a mind game in a way. If you think you can do this, but you kind of know they're going to counter that, it's kind of like difficult to make up things on the fly, so you really have to like think of different ways to overcome the defense.
Generally in Counter-Strike, the North American teams have always struggled against the European teams. It's almost comparable to like soccer. Brazil is going to play USA. Everyone's like, oh, Brazil is just going to stomp them. Well, it's not like they're just better humans. They train harder, right? And it's very simple. So whenever we're competing against Europeans, it's definitely a lot of pride on the table. First game, we start out strong. We beat Mouse Sports, good team from Germany.
Dennis there does actually flash himself up some way. Oh, beautifully done by Skadoodle. Just makes it look so simple.
We lost afterwards to Virtus Pro, one of the top four teams in the world right now, probably.
fREAKAZOID is in a dire predicament. He has very little to work with and even less now.
Best of one format's tough. In a game like Counter-Strike, it comes down to economy, and you can lose two pistol rounds or one pistol round, and it can change a lot. Those are tough games. The final game was versus an opponent, Kinguin. We've only played him one time so far in our tournament history.
So every advantage now leaning towards Cloud9.
It's all or nothing.
2-1 the score, Team Kinguin still up one round. Able to connect that shot, but Scott's gonna be overrun towards long. What a shot onto Dennis! Skadoodle, fREAKAZOID, everybody getting a piece of the action. It's gonna be down to nothing now in a 1v2. What are they doing, Cloud9? Wow, Kinguin, they're just going for the straight up rush on the B side. No subtlety here.
So, unfortunately, we ended the group here at ESL Cologne 1-2.
They've taken out some of the best in the world, and to falter here in the group stage at Cologne, this is the upset.
We lost, and like you can see, like in all of our eyes, we couldn't even believe it.
It's just like, wow. Especially in a game like that when it's so close, there's almost no words.
Knowing you're the better team with better players and how heartbreaking it is for your whole team, that's what hurts the most, is knowing like that you should win. And like, man, it's just hard.
It's almost even hard to talk to each other right away because we all wanted it.
I'm just saying, like in general, like we were set up to stop all of those hits. We fucking fell apart. Like I don't know what more there is to say.
You know, I believe with these guys. Honestly, when they're hurting, I'm hurting too. But I kind of have to pick it up and run with it myself and keep the show going. It can't stop right there, you know? We've got other things to do. We've got other competitions to be in.
It was just more of a bummer. You know, we wanted to play on the big stage, but you've got to be able to live with the losses just as much as the wins. So we're ready for the next event.
Probably the proudest moment, for me at least, is just the fans that we have and all the people who want you to win so bad and all the messages you get after, like, you should have had it. You truly should have had it, you know?
It's amazing that all the fans, like, give us so much support even after, like, a demoralizing loss. And you're like, I don't deserve that after what just happened, you know?
happen. Our jobs wouldn't be possible without all the people who are in this arena, and it's an honor that we have so many people who want to see us at the event and hang out with us.
The pigeon is a logo of Shroud, so someone prints it out, big banner of Shroud.
Giving us all that support definitely just makes us want to win even more.
This team is capable of winning everything. Like, I truly believe it. I don't care if anybody thinks I'm cocky, because if you don't believe it, you're never gonna do it.
We'll be here one day. I can't wait though. We're coming for all the teams, we'll be number one.
I think I was 11 years old and I went to a Fry's Electronics. It's where you buy like computer hardware and whatnot. And I think I saw like an NVIDIA box and I seen someone from Team 3D on the side of the box with a quote. And you know, it wasn't really what they said on the box or anything that inspired me, but I was just looking at them and I knew they were a Counter-Strike player and I knew them from these videos online and it just was like, well, that's so awesome. Being able to be here now and have been on a box and have been in one of those stores is one of the more fulfilling things that I've ever had the pleasure of being a part of in my life.